In the United States video, we looked at the 50 state and the administrative district of Colombia. In this video, we are going to look at the United States territories. U.S. hold claim to 16 territories in Caribbean Sea and Pacific Ocean. This is not small. There are over 140 islands and over 3 million people reside in this area. Not all these territories have the same power either. It's really a complicated mess. But before we pick apart and learn about all 16 territories, could you please do us a favor and subscribe to our channel? This will motivate us to do more video, and I am sure you would like to explore the world with us, don't you? Why do you think US lay claim on these islands? Most of them are far away from the US mainland. There are many good reasons, including political, defensive, and social. There is another more relatable reason, economy. These islands, or the clusters of islands, are surrounded by seafloor that may have important mineral or energy or even marine resources. By claiming this area, United States claim the right to an exclusive economic zone up to 200 miles offshore. And it's also very important to note, some of these territories have played significant part in the World War II. Out of these 16 territories, 5 of them has permanent population. 9 of them are small island, atoll or reef with no native or permanent population. 2 of them are disputed. They are claimed by United States but administered by Colombia. Let's look at the inhabited, unincorporated, organized Commonwealth territories of the United States. Commonwealth of Puerto Rico is located in the northeast part of the Caribbean Sea. Puerto Rico became U.S. territory after the Spanish-American War in 1898. Puerto Ricans are U.S. citizens, but they cannot vote in the U.S. presidential election. No, they can choose their own senator to represent them in the U.S. Congress, but they can vote on the Republican and Democratic primary. That's it. There are many times U.S.-Puerto Rico political relationship have been considered. U.S. presidents have issued 3 executive orders over the years on the subject, and Congress has considered 4 major bills on Puerto Rico's political status. There were quite a few referendums on the subject as well, and the latest one being 2017. In that referenda, Puerto Rican had 3 options to choose. If they want to be a state, or if they want to be an independent country, or they want to keep the current status. 97%, that's an overwhelming 97%, chose statehood. But the turnaround was so low, only 23%, due to boycott from pro-independence movement and pro-Commonwealth supporters. Residence commissioner represents the Puerto Rico, who is a non-voting member of the United States House. He or she is elected by Puerto Rican people, but he or she doesn't have any voting right except for the House committees and stuff. Puerto Rico has a local government, and for the most part, Puerto Rican consider themselves as an independent country. If you ask any Puerto Rican, they would say they are a Puerto Rican. They probably won't say they are an American. Northern Mariana Island is another unincorporated, organized Commonwealth of the United States. That's mouthful. It is located in North Pacific Ocean. After the World War II, the island became under the jurisdiction of United Nations Trust. UN assigned United States as a trustee. There were referendum to see where this island would go. And most of the islanders wanted to be part of Guam. But Guam didn't like the idea. So in the 70s, Northern Mariana Island people decided that they would join United States. And they officially became United States Commonwealth in 1986. Northern Mariana people can elect a delegate to represent them in the Congress House since 2008. The delegates serve as a member of some House committee and they can vote on the House committee, but that's it. Northern Mariana Island people receive US citizens, they follow US rules, they can enlist on any military service, but they lack voting rights. Let's look at the inhabited, unincorporated, organized territories of the United States. So Guam is an unincorporated, organized territory of the United States. It is located in the Pacific Ocean. After the World War II, Guam became part of the US and the residents received their US citizenship. People of Guam are not allowed to vote in the US presidential election. Their congressional representative, also a non-voting member, they do, however, can vote in the presidential primary, similar to the other state territories that we looked at. There is a significant movement in favor of the territory becoming a commonwealth, just like Puerto Rico and Northern Mariana Island. However, there is a competing movement advocating for independence, statehood, or combination with Northern Mariana Island and becoming a single territory. However, US federal government doesn't see any of these as an option for Guam. They are saying that Guam is not financially stable and it's not self-sufficient, and so they won't be able to make any changes. People of Guam really prefers modification and they are looking for it. People of Guam can join the military, but they cannot vote for their president. United States Virgin Islands is an unincorporated but organized territory of the United States of America. It's located in the Caribbean Sea. United States began interest in the island back in 1867. But Denmark wasn't interested in selling the island because they had the ownership at the time. During the World War I, US thought that Germany might use this island as a submarine base. So they asked Denmark again to sell it. Denmark wasn't interested in the beginning, but they decided to sell it for $25 million worth of gold coins. In today's value, it's about $600 million. United States took possession of the island in 1917 and the territory was named Virgin Islands of the United States, since there was another Virgin Island in the Caribbean already. In 1970, Virgin Islanders elected their first governor to represent them in the US Congress. He or she is a non-voting member, and the people of Virgin Island cannot vote for the President of the United States, but they can vote on the primaries, just like the other territories. People born in the US Virgin Islands receive their US citizenship and they can enlist in the army and they will follow all the federal law. Let's look at the inhabited, unincorporated, unorganized territory. American Samoa is an unincorporated, unorganized territory of the United States located in the South Pacific Ocean. In the early 20th century, Germany and United States partitioned the Samoa Islands into two territories. The eastern part went to United States. In the mid-50s, American Samoan had the option to join Samoa, but they chose not to and remain with US. By 1956, locally elected non-voting delegate represent them in the American Congress. It is technically considered an unorganized since US Congress has not passed the Organic Act for the territory yet. According to the Immigration and National Act, people of American Samoa are not citizens. They are nationalists. American Samoan are under US protection when they are traveling. They can travel to US without visa, but to become a US citizen, American Samoan must naturalize just like any other foreigners. And they cannot vote for presidential election. They can vote for the primaries. They can enlist in United States Army and they have to follow federal law. Let's look at the uninhabited, unincorporated, unorganized territories of the United States. Midway Atoll is uninhabited, unincorporated, unorganized territory of the United States and is located in the North Pacific Ocean. As the name suggests, Midway Atoll is roughly an equal distance between North America and Asia. This island was discovered by Captain Brooke in the 1859. He climbed this island for United States. Midway is the only island in the Hawaiian archipelago that is not part of the Hawaiian state. Midway is designated as a National Wildlife Refuge and a National Memorial. Approximately 60 people live and work there at any time. These are not permanent population. Wake Island is an uninhabited, unincorporated, unorganized territory of the United States. It is located in the Western Pacific Ocean. Wake Island was first discovered by Spanish explorers in 1568, but they didn't lay any claim. United States Exploring Expedition surveyed the island in 1841. The main island has an airfield, a missile launch center, and 9,800-foot runway that is the longest one in the Pacific Ocean area there, and the military personnel lives and work there as well. United States administers the island. However, Marshall Island has claim on the island based on the oral legend songs that pass through the generation. Howland Island is an uninhabited, unincorporated, unorganized territory of the United States, which is located in the North Pacific Ocean. The island is best known as the island Amelia Earhart was searching for but never found when her airplane disappeared in 1937. Howland Island was uninhabited when United States took possession of it under the Guano Island Act. Its guano deposits were mined by American companies from 1857 to 1878. Howland Island is designated as National Wildlife Refuge since 1974. Baker's Island is another uninhabited, unincorporated, unorganized territory of the United States in the Pacific Ocean. It is located halfway between Hawaii and Australia. Captain Baker climbed this island back in 1855. Then he sold his interest to few people and they formed a guano company and they mined the guano deposits in the mid-1800. If you're wondering what guano is, it's a seabird and bat poo. Yeah, you heard me right. It's a poo. It's a highly effective fertilizer. Now, no one lives in the island, but in the 1942, there was a small population. It is now a national wildlife refuge for seabird, shorebirds, and marine turtle. Johnson Atoll is an uninhabited, unincorporated, unorganized territory of the United States. Johnson Atoll is comprised of four islands atop of a coral reef platform, located about 860 miles southwest of Hawaii. It is one of the world's most isolated locations. Captain Charles Johnston located this island in 1807. By 1858, the United States claimed the island, and also Kingdom of Hawaii claimed the island. It bounced back between the two places until Hawaii joined the United States as a territory. Johnson Atoll was not part of the deal. By 1890, all the guanos were mined out. Johnson Atoll was never had any indigenous inhabitants, although during the last part of the 20th century, there were average of about 300 American military personnel and 1,000 civil contractors lived and worked in this island at any given time. Johnson Atoll is now a national wildlife refuge. Kingman Reef is a largely a submerged, uninhabited, triangular-shaped reef. Located in the North Pacific Ocean, it is one of the unincorporated, unorganized territories of the United States. Kingman Reef was discovered by American Captain Fanning in 1798. Reef was claimed by United States in 1860 under the Guano Act. But there were no evidence of any guano existed or ever mined it. Since the early 1940s, Kingman Reef has very little contact with human. Once in a while, amateur radio operators from around the world visit there to set up a temporary radio station or antenna. Yavas Island is an unincorporated, uninhabited, unorganized territory of the United States. It is located in the South Pacific Ocean. U.S. surveyed the island in 1841 and claimed it in 1857 under the Guano-Aglaland Act. Beginning of 1858, several structures were built to support the mining, including an 8-room superintendent house, and guano mining was in full swing until it was abandoned in 1879, leaving behind a dozen of buildings and 8,000 tons of guano. New Zealand and the United Kingdom mined guano after that. Yavas Island was reclaimed by United States in 1935. There were people living on that island until 1942. Now it is an island for wildlife. It's a national wildlife refuge. Navassa Island is an uninhabited, unincorporated, unorganized territory of the United States. It is a small island about 35 miles west of Haiti in Caribbean Sea. The U.S. has claim of the island since 1857 based on Guano Island Act. Haiti has claim over the Navassa Island goes back to 1697. They established the French possession and it was transferred to Haiti by a treaty. Haiti's 1801 constitution also claimed other adjacent island, but it doesn't name Navassa by its name. Since its 1874 constitution, after establishment of United States claim, Haiti explicitly named Nevesa as one of their territory and it claims. However, the island is currently administered by United States Fish and Wildlife Service, and U.S. Lighthouse Service has built a lighthouse in there, and U.S. Coast Guard services the light. It is designated as National Wildlife Refuge now. Let's look at the uninhabited, unincorporated, but organized territories. Palmyra Atoll is an unoccupied, unincorporated, but organized territory. Only one of its kind. It is located in the North Pacific Ocean. The first known sighting of the Palmyra came in 1798. U.S. claimed the island in 1859. The small atoll has quite a history. A buried treasure story inspired a book, a private ownership battle that went to Supreme Court, and the murder, possibly a double murder, and a claim for Hawaii. Now the island is a national wildlife refuge and a national monument. And it is home to over 150 species of coral and many more marine life. There are few scientists and staff live and work there as part of the US government work. They do research and study. Tourists are allowed to visit Palmyra Atoll. However, you need to have a permission before visiting. Let's look at the disputed territories of the United States. Bojnobang is an uninhabited, unorganized, unincorporated territory of the United States. It is essentially a reef with a small grass inlet and is located in the Western Caribbean Sea. Colombia currently claim this area. Jamaica and Honduras also laid claim on the reef, but they each have an agreement with Colombia regarding the fishing boundaries. So, signing these treaties were regarded as a de facto recognition of Colombian domain over this area. Nicaragua had a claim too, but they went to international court and the justice decided that the area is belong to Colombia back in 2012. United States claimed the area in 1869 under the Guano Island Act. Most claim made by U.S. over this agreement in this area were announced in a treaty back in 1972. But Bojnobang was not mentioned in the treaty. Now, Colombia has administrative control over this island, so it's disputed. Serenilla Bank was a disputed, uninhabited, unorganized, unincorporated territory of the United States. It is essentially a reef with small inlet located in the Western Caribbean Sea next to Bojnobang. The history is very similar and the claims are too. The Serenilla Bank was first shown in Spanish map in 1510. Colombia and Jamaica have an agreement to utilize the sea area. They both do have claim. Honduras had a claim. However, they signed an agreement with Colombia and they lost all control over the area. United States claim was made back in 1879 and 1880 under the Guano Island Act. Most of the island under these act were renounced, but not Serenilla, same as Bajo, so it's still disputed. You made it. If you are still here, pat your back. This is intense, but I hope it's interesting too. Did you learn something new? We are going to do more video on these 5 inhabited territories. There's a lot more to learn. Please subscribe and comment, and don't forget to click the bell button so you will know when we upload the video next time. So you can join us in exploring the whole world one country at a time. Thank you for watching. Please comment and let us know what you think.